What's happening, everybody? Welcome back. This is Forgo. And after extensive testing with all kinds of different things available in the game, I think I found pretty much the best setup as far as getting the most damage against Nightmare Geese. Now, in reality, this really isn't that important because all you need is 1.25 billion. But I gotta say, guys, since everybody was able to get this free IV, we are having a lot of fun trying to get these really big scores. Now, unfortunately, two of these characters on this team, a lot of players won't have, but these characters will come back in the future, and you really should pull for them because in all reality, guys, both of them are awesome because you only need them at level 90 to get what you want, and you only need a 3PG for one of them, which is actually pretty fantastic. And you can take a lot of the tips and tricks that I'm going to give you today and apply to different teams that you could be using, you know, against, you know, your guild raid runs. I'm going to be working on Omega Rugal, but I did do a recording last night as far as Nightmare Geese to show you guys just how much I've improved on my guild raid score. The best score you guys have seen from me is, I think, like 680 billion, something like that. And guys, it is far surpassed now. It is ridiculous how much more damage I'm able to do because of the changes I made. So the optimal team, guys, is really you're going to want to have Athena, Cronin, and then, of course, we're going to be using free Ivy. Now, Athena, you will need the 3PG for her. And if you don't have this 3PG, the SS3PG that comes with her will work. This one right here, it will work for her. You can absolutely use this thing. And if you guys want to see that, I can show you that in the future. But we're going to be running the set here that we're getting for Holderoo on Athena because it really does help as far as gaining that extra critical damage. But something you're going to notice in the run, even though my Athena is at A1, we're not going to be using her Awakened skill. Now, I realize whenever you use the Awakened skill, it increases attack by 20%. But guys, I have done this run 20 million different times. I can't tell you how many times I've done it. And for whatever reason there is, if I don't hit the Awakened skill, I just do way more damage. In fact, there's about 100 billion difference in the build of my characters as far as the runs, 100 billion. If I don't use the Awakened skill, I gain about 100 billion points. So if whatever the reason is, I'm gaining it. But we're still going to be getting a lot of critical damage, which is nice. Now, the other character, and also, guys, Athena, is because her second skill offers increased attack by 100% to all allies and the penetration by 5,000. Now, a lot of players, what they think is if you hit the second skill twice and then you hit the first skill once, it won't work. But what you gotta remember, guys, when it comes to Athena, is that her psychic dress-up kit, this effect will mainstay as long as you don't change this. So if you hit the first skill just one time, you're not going to be getting this increased damage by, or this critical damage and critical rate by 90%. It's not going to be, you know, up. You're only going to have the second skill 100% attack if you only tap this first skill one time. If you want to play it safe, you can always just hit the three and just hit the second skill twice, apply your chill and shock, and be done with it. And then you know for sure that you're not, you know, taking a chance of hitting your first skill twice. So it's always with Athena, guys. You drop her in, you go three, and hit the second skill twice. Now, in the run you guys are going to watch, a lot of times I'm just going to be dropping her in and hitting her second skill twice because I do have a super armor card on her. So I don't have to worry about, I mean, I can take damage, but I don't have to worry about getting interrupted by Geese. So if I have enough PG and I drop in and hit that second skill twice, I can go into my 3PG immediately and have the chill and shock applied all at the same time. This is important, guys, because it's all about speed. The faster you are, the higher score that you can actually get. The faster you can run through your rotations, the higher score that you're actually going to get. Now, the next character is Cronin, and I want to touch on this because Cronin is a character that's pretty godly. Now, I can tell you guys that this card set does make a difference. For a long time, I've been speculating whether or not it does make a difference, and it does. The increased target damage received on this crap is nuts, and the nice thing about it is it lasts for 8 seconds, which is amazing, guys. This is nice. Now, it's only increased target damage received by 10%, but still 10% makes a big difference in your damage. So this set does roll around every once in a while in the game, and players will be able to acquire it over time, but it is a really great set to have on the character that you're going to use before you switch to your main damage dealer. Whatever character it may be, whether it's Leona, Bison, whoever it may be, this set will be really good on the last character that you use before you switch to your next character. And the last character that you use, you're not going to be using their 3PG as well, which is actually pretty damn awesome. The other thing about Cronan, though, guys, himself, is all the increased target damage speed he has. And this is why whenever you see these super, super OP runs, Cronan is usually on the team. And guys, he only needs to be level 90 for this. Just like Athena, just level 90 to get that 100% attack. That's all you need. But Cronan, when he fully charges his third skill, guys, and this does have hyper armor, he gives an increased target damage speed by 40% for 6 seconds. Now, this is really, really important because you only get a 6 second window. Once you bring in Cronan and you apply his third skill, fully charge that thing, then let it release, you're only gonna get this increased target damage speed for 6 seconds. So it's very, very vital and important for the highest damage possible that you can do to be able to break the meter as soon as possible when you bring in Cronan or whatever character that you're switching to your damage dealer. So that way you get all these buffs applied for a longer amount of time. That's going to make a huge difference in your damage. The other thing about Cronan, guys, is whenever he does his second skill, he gets another increased target damage dealt by 25% for 5 seconds. Remember, this is only for 5 seconds, right? When he does Heat Shield and it resets Fusion Blaster. So whenever you're playing with this character, you're going to hit the third skill, hold it all the way down after you bring in Athena, and then you're going to let it go, and then you're going to hit the first skill, and then you're going to hit the second skill, Heat Shield. It's going to give that 5 seconds of increased target damage speed from his core, and then it's going to reset the third skill. So literally, you go three, fully charge it, first skill, second skill, third skill, and just tap it. And the thing is about Cronan is that his third skill, these things will stack on top of each other. So if you fully charge this skill, hit that 40% increased target damage speed, and then go first skill, second skill, get the increased target damage speed from his second skill, right? And then it resets the third skill, and you tap it, you'll get another 30% increased target damage received for 6 seconds, guys. That is 70% increased target damage received on top of the 25%. It's 95% increase to target damage received. This is why he's so OP, but I'll show you something else that makes a big difference as far as damage, right? And that, my friends, is certain stones that you can put on. Now, this first stone, guys, is actually from the Volume 5 banner. And this stone actually decreases defenses by 50% for 5 seconds. So again, guys, it's extremely important. You only have a small window where you're gonna have this effect applied after you bring in your character that has these stones on them to get this decreased defenses by 50%. So again, speed is very, very important. The timing of breaking your meter is super, super important. So, you know, we get this from Cronan, right? And then the second skill, or second stone, is also a Volume 6 stone that also decreases defense by 50%. That's 100% decreases in defenses, all right? Again, you only have a 5 second window. And then the third stone is actually the Volume 5 again, which increases target damage received by 12%. So we have a lot of increased target damage received in here, right? A lot, guys. It's just a tremendous amount on this character with the card set, with the stones, with his kit. Like, this is what makes such a huge, huge difference for your main damage dealer. This guy is crazy. And again, at level 90, guys, you don't even need his 3PG. You don't need his 3PG, guys. You'll see, I'll never use it. I'll never use it at all. Just OP. Now, the next thing that I want to show you guys is another adjustment that you can make to your Ivy. Now, we got this Soul Calibur set. We're running this set on her, guys, which is pretty OP, right? But when it comes to her stones, this stone made a huge difference for her. And this stone actually increases EX critical damage by 30%, which is OP for Ivy because she pretty much gets max critical rate as long as you have the Soul Calibur set on her. It is OP, guys. It makes it a tremendous difference in your damage. Now, this is from Volume 7. So if you have this stone and you put it on your Ivy, you're going to get even more damage out of her. I've experimented with other stones, other EX stones in here, and it didn't help the damage at all. But this one made a big difference. So that's another tip that I can give you as far as stones. So you saw the stones on Cronan. You know, those are the kind of stones you'd want to use on your character that you're going to be using as your last character before you switch to your main damage dealer. And then for Ivy, if you give her this stone right here, if you have it, it's going to be OP. And something to keep in mind, guys, is if you don't have any of these stones, right, if you're missing some of these stones, just remember that in future banners, some of these stones will be available. And I will, you know, keep let you know whether or not maybe you should go for certain stones, level up a character at a certain point to get the certain stones so you can get the highest damage possible, right? So let me bring up the run for you guys, and we'll just kind of talk about it. Now, when it comes to your strikers, actually, I just want to show you the strikers while I can, all right? So the strikers that you want to use for this team setup, right? Remember, we got the set cards for Hodoru on Athena. We have the Geese set on Cronin, right? Now, I'm going to be using Lady Choi as my striker. Now, you don't have to use Lady Choi, guys. If you use a striker that increases power, that's really all you want. Lady Choi is pretty insane because she offers, you know, obtains 20% power at the start of the stage, obtains 10% power when using an ultimate move. I mean, it's just OP. It makes things really, really easy as far as doing your 3PG. But this version of Athena actually gives 10% power, so she's really, really good. There's other characters in the game that actually offer power as well. I mean, if you click on power here, guys, and click on power, you can see other characters that might offer power as a striker. Shizuru here, which is a free character, she offers power as well. There's all kinds of them that offer power gain. So you just kind of go through and figure out which one is going to work out the best. I think, yeah, I mean, Yuri here, again, you know, you got some power right there. This version of Honka, 15% power, and so on and so on and so on. But using a striker that gains power is really going to be a good way for you to go. Now, when it comes to Cronin, guys, we're going to be using Lucky. Now, Lucky is really, really important because he decreases tag cooldowns of fighters by 1.5 seconds. This is going to decrease the tag cooldown of Ivy, because what you'll find, guys, in the rotation whenever you're using Athena and Cronin is that Ivy will still have a couple seconds left on her tag cooldown, right? So you're losing a lot of damage. Remember, you only got a 5 second window with the decreased defenses on his on Cronin's imprint stones. You only got 6 seconds of increased target damage received, right? You're losing a lot of damage if you're not able to bring in Ivy sooner. So having Lucky as a striker is actually really, really amazing. It's very, very good. It makes a huge difference in your damage. Now here we have Okita, okay? Now, again, guys, when it comes to Okita, he gives critical damage by 30%. But if you look into here, you'll find that there are other characters that offer critical damage, like Leona, who gives critical damage by 30% too. So you could just level this character up, free to play, and use her instead of Okita, right? Just use her instead of Okita, right? And that's going to make a big, big difference in your damage. Now, let me pull up the run and I'll just kind of guide you guys through what I'm doing. So, whenever we start off the run, guys, we're going to switch straight to Ivy, okay? And it doesn't matter if you apply darkness or not. You just want to get that 3PG off. As soon as the 3PG goes off, do not bring in your striker. Don't bring in your striker at all. Just bring in Ivy, okay? Now, after you do her 3PG, you're going to bring in Cronin really quick, right? Fully charge the first skill, first turn. And then you're going to bring in Athena, bring in your striker so you can build your PG super fast, and always end on the second skill twice. Once you do the second skill twice, you're going to drop her in. Now, here's where, now what I've done there is I hit my third skill, and so because the third skill will bring you forward, but honestly, guys, you can just hit the second skill twice. It'll be the same thing, but I always like to hit the third skill to build up a little bit of PG, because right there, you can see down at the bottom, we got 3 bars of PG. It's not quite ready, but once I hit that second skill, it'll be about ready. That way, the next and the next rotation, whenever I drop her in, her 3PG is pretty much ready to go once I hit her second skill twice. That's something I'm always watching, is how much PG gain I actually have on my Athena. Now, after I apply that second skill twice, we're going to immediately bring in Cronin. Now watch what I do. All right, Cronin. The third skill fully charged, then the first skill, then we get the increased target damage from the second skill, and then the third skill again, and then we switch straight to Ivy. Now look at the damage that we did, guys, in one rotation. Look at the damage we did in one rotation. 94 billion, guys. 94 billion. Those decreased defensive stones, the increased target damage received from the card set, from the stone, the set on Athena, the 100% attack from Athena, all these things are making a tremendous difference in our damage. That is insanity to do that much damage in one rotation, right? okay? So again, now something to keep in mind, guys, if you are using Athena, do not apply darkness. Don't apply darkness. She will break the meter way too fast and throw your rotation all off. So we drop her in, we hit the third scale and the second scale twice, right? We'll do this, and we're just gonna hit our third and second scale twice again, and then we're gonna bring in Cronin, okay? Second scale. Cronin, fully charged, first, second, third, and then bring in Ivy. And then make sure you always bring in your Striker as well. I mean, guys, look at this, okay? Look at this, right? In two rotations, she already did 200 billion. In two rotations, 200 billion. And you just keep that cycle going and going and going and going, okay? Now, I'm going to let it play a little bit further because I want to show you guys what to do whenever Geese goes into an I-frame, okay? Now, I realize we got, you know, Guild Raid Rugal today, but this might help some of you next week, okay? Now, I think after this is when Geese is going to go into an I-frame. It might be the rotation afterwards, but we'll see. If not, we'll just let it play a little bit further, okay? All right, so Geese is going to go, see there, we broke the meter. Now, I want you guys to notice there that we had about, you know, maybe a second left on the tech cooldown for Ivy, so we actually lost a little bit of damage there. It's very, very important to break that meter and Ivy be ready whenever you bring her in, so you get all the increased target damage received, all the decreased defenses by 50% for that 5 second duration, guys. That is very, very important. It makes a huge, huge difference in your runs, a massive difference, especially if you have these stones and cards and all these things equipped. Now, Geese is gonna go into an I-frame. All right, now watch. Now, here's the beautiful thing about Athena. Whenever you use your second skill for Athena, this is another reason you guys should pull for her whenever she comes in the future, she applies the chill and shock no matter what, whether he's in an I-frame or not. Whereas with some dots, it doesn't work that way. By the way, Ivy's Darkness works the same way. So I can hit the second skill and not worry from Athena, and not worry about the dots not being applied. So now the dots are applied, we're just gonna drop in Cronin, and I want you to look at the timing of when I use Cronin's skills. Okay, now I want you to look at that again. I'm gonna kind of back up a little bit here, okay? Now I want you to look, whenever Geese takes his hands, he's in an I-frame when his hands are up, guys. When his hands go down, that's when you wanna go and start hitting your skills. When his hands go down, start hitting your skills, okay? So in Cronin's case, that's when I hit my third skill, first, second, third again, and then switch to Ivy. We already got the dot applied from Athena. Now watch, now you see Geese's hands up right now. I'm not attacking. He's in an I-frame right now. Once his hands drop, then you're going to attack. Hands drop, boom, I let it go, and then go into my rest of my skills, and I switch to Ivy. And boom, that's exactly how you want to do it, right? And as you guys can see, the damage is pretty wild. I'm going to leave you guys the full run at the end of this video, but you're going to be pretty damn shocked by how much damage I've done because, you know, previously, guys, like I said earlier, I did like 680 billion, but with all these changes to the one stone on Ivy, to the three stones on Cronin, to the card set that I have on Cronin, to the set card that's from Hodoru on Athena, all these things have made a massive, massive difference. And you can take these things and apply it to your Guild Raid runs and see if you can improve your Guild Raid runs. Now, if you guys want, you can put down your team in the comments. Let me know what teams you're trying to use, and I will try to do a video about it if I can. I mean, I probably can't get to everybody, but I'll do the best I can as far as, you know, trying to cover a different basis or a different team composition as far as doing runs in Guild Raid. Also, guys, I want to throw out a little something to all of you. If you're interested in joining my guild, we have 13 openings in this guild, and actually we have quite a few openings in my free-to-play guild as well. So if you're interested in joining one of my guilds, please join me in Discord. The link is in the description below, and contact me, guys, and we'll get it done. We'll get it done, man. Right now I'm on vacation, so I got plenty of time to get it all squared away, get you guys in there. If you're looking for a good guild and people that participate, and by the way, speaking of participating, all I ask, guys, is that you come in, log in every day, and, you know, play this stupid game mode here, and I do think it's stupid, I hate it, but play this game mode. No matter what your scores are, guys, I don't care. I don't care what your scores are. Just come in here, play this thing, right? Play your guild raids, and that's all you really need to do. So guys, let me know if this video helped any of you out as far as your guild raid runs. Let me know what teams you would like to see in the future. And I do stream on Twitch at 9 p.m. GT+7 time. The link is in the description below. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. Y'all take care and have a good one. See everybody. Take care.